With greetings, I continued a discussion on the famous celebrated trial scene, its dramatic significance. And you just have a look at this stage performance by Royal Shakespeare Company and this, you know, Merchant of Venice, this trial scene. It was performed on the stage and really it received a great applause. And it was really highly impressive. And you see the characters here, we have Portia now very tactfully with her remarkable prudence, brilliance, she tackles the case. And see the Antonio here and Shiloh, you know, he's very eager to have judgment. And see when she enters and her famous dialogue, a trance, which is the merchant and which the Jew. So when you write the significance of title, it is crystal clear here that Antonio, yes, of course, he is the merchant of Venice. So see, which is the merchant and which is the Jew. And, you know, then we have, see the Duke, the character. He has full faith in the law of Venice. Yes. It is the court of justice and Royal Shakespeare Company, you know, it performed this commendable play on the stage. So this was really, you know, highly praised by the people around in the world. And therefore, students, you would also enjoy this and the how, you know, the women of substance, how the queen, the center of attraction, Portia, she with her, you know, worldly wisdom, with her remarkable knowledge on legal matters, she deals with this, you know, special case. And that's why she says, you know, her utterance, she says, oh, strange nature of this bond. And see, no discussion on this famous trial scene can be completed without the focus on of the famous, yeah, here, you know, Shylock also have a look, he's insistent on the bond, I will have my bond, and so adamant is, you know, his villainy, it is reflected, and Shylock, and he's so eager all the time, he's after the life of Antonio, and therefore, you know, we have now, you see the reflection of various important dimensions. They are integrated with the law of Venice. Yes, the justice and the discussion on, yes. Now we have just focused on the blessings. I mean, this is famous. Portia's speech. Portia's speech of quality of mercy. Yes. Now what are important points, students? I mean, this is a must. This is the pivotal point that the students of literature, they should have better and deeper understanding of this famous celebrated speech, because you know, Portia, she herself, you know, center of attraction, and now what is the reason that she has become very popular? Because of virtues, because of the treasure of virtues. Now when she commences this, see the idea here. First of all, it is, yes, the quality of mercy is not strained. Yes, it droppeth as the gentle rain from heaven. So, remarkable simile here we have. Mercy, it is just like benediction of God, blessings of God, gentle draws of rain from heaven, and which is the abode of God. It's not a sort of, you know, a pressure or compulsion. It's a natural outcome. And its flow is spontaneous. And another important point is this twice blessed. Yes. Both for especially, you know, who shows mercy and those who receive mercy. So showing and receiving. So this is, you know, as it is a famous maxim that in giving you receive, giving and receiving, simultaneously. That's why benediction of God, God's blessing, and you know, it is an attribute to God himself. As if, you know, here she points out, see, this is the famous, have a look, of this famous droplet, and this is blessed him, the quiet, and they, you know, can give and him the teeth. So both for the person who shows mercy and who receives. Now see, this is the mightiest, in the mightiest it becomes. Now, and the throned monarch better than his crown. So here, throned monarch, why, what is the reason behind it? It is the most powerful authority in the world. Yes, if you have this quality, yes, you have become strong, powerful in the world. And you know, another we have metaphor here, metaphor of strength through these virtues, through these qualities. And therefore, see, another point I would like to focus here, the most powerful, yes, and what is the reason behind it? Because highest authority given by God. It's not that you have formed your own rules and you have, you know, you are not following the God's rules and instructions and regulations. No, there is a remote control. And that's why mightiest, most powerful. And when we talk about kings and monarchs, even for them it is very important. Yes, obviously for all the human beings, the quality of mercy is important. But yes, for kings and monarchs. Why it is important? Because it decorates them. It embellishes them. So decoration. Now decoration through good qualities. So this is one of the important qualities. And it's better than the crown. Why? What is the reason? Because the scepter. Now what is scepter? Meaning of this, you know, the rod of authority. Yes, the king, you know, he is the most powerful and he has got the highest authority of that particular place. So in a way, it may be now that this scepter, this rod of authority, it can be, you know, symbol of apprehension, fear. But no, mercy, it is higher and greater. It has, you know, some kind of natural qualities which are very attractive, very fascinating, and that make your personality fascinating, effective, impressive. And that's why Portia, she herself, she has become very popular. And you know, because of her modesty, because of her, say, grace, emblem of virtues, and women of substance. So all this substantial point she possesses. So salvation, she also points out the salvation, even, you know, in so far as spirituality is concerned. See, Portia's worldly wisdom, here it is reflected in Shakespeare with his remarkable dramatic skills. He, you know, especially through the utterance of Portia, he himself tends to express his views on these virtues. And I mean, this is the specific purpose of his famous drama. Now, in which, now if you are free from all the sin, if you have this good quality, and therefore the purpose is fulfilled. Now here, Portia also points out here, she focuses this point. What is her purpose? Yes. And her purpose, specific purpose, is to just, you know, change the mind of Shylock. And this is her purpose, the deeds of mercy. I have spoke this much to mitigate me, to lessen and to reduce something. Or say in a way, in simpler way, just to change the mind, mold the mind of this hard-hearted, stony-hearted person. And therefore, she wants to justify the law of Venice. Now, here, see, another important point in this famous scene. And, you know, we have several time the word, you know, authority, and we have see the word power and vanish and law of vanish, and especially say when you know Shylock and Antonio's utterance, when we have a look particularly at the these utterances, we have, you know, reiteration of the word justice and judgment repeatedly. Even, you know, Antonio also, he is of the opinion, but you know, Portia at this time, she also insists on that. And what is that? Yes, it is the authority. And it is at the same time she wants to justify the significance and righteousness of the law. Now, at this time, I would like to focus on the dramatic significance of this. Dramatic significance of particularly this famous scene. Now, so far as characters are concerned, you know, Bassanio, he is very close friend. So, his relationship with Antonio, it reaches consummation. And see, the Portia as a wife of Bassanio, she expresses her personality. It is sort of reflection of her remarkable personality that she is capable of tackling several situations, and she would get success in that. And then we have symbolical significance of the court also, when she repeatedly she points out attribute of God and God himself and mightiest, and you know, it's a quality God, even as if semblance of God is there. If you have got this quality, there is obviously the semblance of God. Now, point wise, as earlier also I told you that very in systematic way you can have better idea about this famous scene, in which just have a look of this. See, this is very simpler way of having better idea. Now, what are important steps so far as development of plot is concerned? Now, we have dramatic effect of this. And see, in the beginning, you know, Portia, all the time, you know, she insists on that, oh, we would, you know, establish the judgment and all that. And yes, Shylock, and she's, you know, very cleverly, and we have some kind of comical impact also. See, in the beginning, when this court scene, it commences, at that time, when it starts, at that time, there is an element of sort of tension, anxiety, and all the people, they are so much worried about Antonio's welfare. But when she enters, yes, this is, you know, a drastic change in the atmosphere also. Atmosphere, it becomes very light-hearted. And the way she, you know, tackles, and you know, see the dialogue, very important dialogue, in which she points out that, yes, let me have a look of this bond. And repeatedly, you know, when Shylock also insists, Shylock, he's so eager to proceed and eager to rather take pound of flesh from Antonio's body. So this is, you know, his cruelty. Antonio also, he is of the opinion that he's, you know, very naturally he's accepting. See, the proceed the judgment. So repetition of the word judgment is very important. Antonio is also of the opinion. And Shylock, yes, very cunningly. So judgment as entire, we have, you know, the scene, we have a metaphor of this judgment, metaphor of balance also at the same time. And see, his cruel, extreme extent of Shylock's cruelity nearest the heart. And at the time, you know, Antonio, you know, his goodness, his nobility is also reflected here when he points out that, yes, I am very well prepared for that. give. And now then we have, you know, emotional outburst of this, these two friends. When say Bassanio is also very upset. Obviously, it's quite natural that, and he feels guilty also. His intimacy, no doubt, it is justified, but at the same time, because of his friend, sake of his friend, he is ready to sacrifice life. That's why in the beginning, do you remember, we have theme of ideal friendship between the two friends. So he is, at the same time, we come to know about Shylock's very, very, you know, adamant, and he all the time, he is after, he's crazy after, and he has become in a way psychic. And that's why Shakespeare, through these utterances, he tends to reflect the villainy and therefore the purpose of this quote, Law of Venice. And now at the same time, Shakespeare's purpose is to establish the significance of Venetian judgment. And Bassanio, I mean, this is the scene in which, you know, meeting the final, in a way, ironically, we have dramatic irony also in this. When Antonio Bassanio, you know, very, we have comical impact also, because Portia, she is in the disguise of, yes, Balthazar, a young lawyer. And nobody, you know, recognizes her. And this is, see, the sharing with audience and readers. They must have idea about it. But here, Antonio Bassanio, this is very comical. It creates sometimes hilarious laughter later on, when, you know, we have dramatic significance of Ring episode also. And in which she, Bassanio, he says, yes, I am married to a wife and it is dear to me. But now the idea underlying is that he just wants to highlight the intimacy, his intimacy with Antonio. And that's why he has quoted this example. He's giving the example that even he is ready to sacrifice that also for the life of, or the welfare of Antonio. Now, then we have another important points here, that now Portia, when she asks to, you know, particularly, yes, lay bare your bosom. See, very dramatic impact here. Mystery and suspense, what would happen? Everybody is in the court, is worried, and, you know, and to some extent, we have atmosphere of, say, anxiety, curiosity. But Portia, when she utters, and she, the way she asks, yes, the atmosphere, it is lightened. And, you know, she is going towards creating very harmonious atmosphere, congenial atmosphere among the people. And Shylock, when he points out, see, these also, you know, these dialogues, these utterances, when, oh, near the most upright judge, and all these repeatedly, and Gratianio's mimicry also of these, ironical dialogue, when most upright judge, and all this, Daniel comes to judgment. See here, see, this is the, see the climax of this. And climax, as I told you earlier, it is the most exciting moment when Bassanio, he is so much worried, entire court is, you know, is getting tensed, and what would happen? We have atmosphere of mystery. And see, even at the same time, comical impact also, when Gratianio also, he very outspoken, and he says, I have a wife whom I protest, and he's also ready to sacrifice. I mean, they want to save, anyhow, they want to save Antonio's life. So this is, the final part we are going towards. Yes, the turning point. When, what happens? See the scene. And you have this, have seen this famous, popular dramatic performance in which Antonio is standing with his bare bosom, and Bassanio is crazy after our most rightful judge, and repeatedly he, you know, as he's so overwhelmed at this, and you know, his villainy is highlighted, his cruelty, inhumanity, and you know, and he, you know, is absolutely without any emotions and feelings. So this is extreme extent of say being inhumane. Now Shylock, most learned judge. Now tarry a little. Yes, this is the turning point, students. Mind you, be attentive. There is something else. An entire scene, the tables are turned. Yes, very, very significant here. This is, it marks the turning. Tarry means wait. You said that you have judgment. So something else means everything. Yes, where it is, you know, I think this must be the focal part of it. And which is the final judgment. And the judgment which will be always righteous. We have poetic justice that we are. Yes, we will be, you know, looking forward for that. And then a pound of flesh. See, two important arguments. As an expert lawyer, even, you know, Shylock's beyond imagination, repeatedly he was saying most rightful judge, but she said wait. And this wait, it marks the remarkable change, turning point. Yes, we will continue.